too. That back on your tail, come up the way behind. Some pretty good racing going on there. How'd the track work for you?
Track was really good.
Well, it comes down to the final lap there. You got preparation for the checkered flag there.
You know, it's pretty much later on hanging out on the go for it there.
But you did come out 2 seconds in front of them.
Well, I'll tell you how close it is here. We got the printout here. It was a 0.044 difference in the trophy dash.
0.042 difference
in the main.
Love the trash bombs, they don't lie. Hey, who's got a special thanks for?
People walking, Jada Hogwood, and like a shout out to the Keel family.
Congratulations,
man. We'll be seeing you for the rest of the year. What's going
on? Well, hopefully we get that series to throw a vision and all that, and hopefully next year maybe we might have four races to put in for the year. But how do you feel about that, getting other people coming out of the races?
You did a great job. You got a great looking car and all that. Who's got a good punch to?
I can give thanks to my crew. Obviously, nobody can do this out here without the crew. The owner, Don Billings. I tore this car out a couple weeks ago as a racing, and that was all my doing. And he did Val and I put the thing back together. So I got to obviously thank him.
Well, with the traffic conditions, we were looking at a little dry slick there and all that. It was more of a driver's track than a horsepower track and all that. A lot of finesse there. Tell us how the track worked for you. Obviously, it worked well.
Track was good. It was a lot of bike down one and two. And pretty dry slick. It was really good. I mean, I had to handle it down there.
Great job, man. I always hate to talk to you, but congratulations. All right, who's got the 72 car over here?
You're going to get somebody else a chance.
Hey, Chris, hey, are you ready, buddy?
Well, just everyone here keeps helping me on this weekly basis. All the guys here that put in time. Wife for putting up with me in the shop 3 or 4 nights a week. And the guys in the shop for taking care of me. And just everyone for pitching in with their time. Obviously, all the guys will just help me keep this going.
Well, it does take a lot of people in every vocation, from the very top all the way down to the bottom. 72 cars are living around there, buddy.
Yeah. Well, everything in this car, whatever gets better, which is better than the car, I'm just tired. I mean, you know, like I've been a little
you guys all for coming down and coming to the show. Congratulations. Gonna move on down here to the 15 car, old Lightfoot here. Featherfoot. What are you calling it, Matt? Matt, good job, buddy. Congratulations. Whatever it was, you come out victorious.
Start your finish. Track a little dry stick, but it seems like you like that kind of stuff. Well, you got a Lawrence O'Connor there, the 27 car, patient man, because I tell you what, if that would have been me sooner or later, I would have done something down to kind of punt us both or something. But, you know, it's kind of a good deal that you could race with these guys, and tell us about that.
Yeah, it's really nice. You know, I felt him back there the whole time. I knew he was there. But, you know, racing with these guys up here is really a great bunch of race. You know, there's a lot more out there.
So you guys obviously hit the setup there for the dry slick track tonight. More of a driver's track than anything. I mean, you know, it was a big horsepower over here, and you made it, but